Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Kingdom of Wrestling Empire.
Yes, welcome. Ladies and gentlemen, the first matchup is scheduled for one fall. Entering first, weighing in at 215 pounds with heavy hands, standing at a height of 5'8". The undefeated from Colorado, Mr. UFC, Brent Darkstorm.
Dad?
I will annex you first. I'm sorry, I screwed up. You can kill me later.
You just
beat me up later. So we got Anarchy as a special ref.
Okay, now you can introduce the first competitor.
I'm not sure that's actually a punishment, Anarchy. We all love to see you.
Okay, and?
I thought I'd join you on comms. Hello, everybody. I'm just going to hang out with you for a little bit, if you don't mind.
I mind.
Okay, and I will care about that eventually, because you are just extra sass, and that is your job. I'm allowed to do that. How are you? Just like everybody here is allowed to have an opinion about what happens in this ring. So, Kat, I heard something about somebody from Colorado. Let's bring them out.
Yes, let's try this again. Take two. Okay. Or take three, whatever it is. Okay, standing at a height of 5'8", weighing in at 215 with heavy hands, the undefeated from Colorado, Mr. UFC Brent Darkstorm.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event. Let's get ready to rumble!
Y'all ready for this?
Alright, we got ourselves a Brent! Welcome, Brent! Okay, you real athlete. Oh, well, English must not be his first language.
No. His opponent!
His opponent?!
His opponent, guys! We got an opponent! Standing at 6'8", 285 pounds, hailing from Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, USA. We have the Cyber Skull, Dominic Surge.
Well, I'm not going to call this one David versus Goliath. I'm going to call this one the blind versus the mute. There we go. It's Brent Darkstorm. Well, Brent Darkstorm is so full of himself. Poor guy. No matter how much they try, I don't think he'll learn. See, right there. He's proving my point every time he opens his mouth.
I think he's confused. It looks like he's facing a beast.
Possibly. I mean, English is not his first language, so I could be just interpreting that very wrong. You know, maybe he is giving the pasty masked one there a compliment.
He's from USC, right?
Yeah, but that's something from Colorado, so...
No,
that...
I mean, maybe he got hit in the head from anything.
Well, either way, there's the bell, and Brent is expelling a lot of energy while... Don is keeping his prosthetic limbs batteries charged.
I don't know. I don't know what all is cybernetic on him. And, oh, a big boot knocking the blind one down. Brent is, yeah, see, there you go. I said he's blind. He's blind. He didn't see the boot coming. He cannot see reality. And that's that. Dominic Surge yanking him. Poising him into position here. Dom knowing exactly once he wants. A nice hug, and that is not friendly as it turns into an overhead belly-to-belly slam. Dominic Surge getting to work easy, and he just kicked him. Oh, dear Lord. Dominic Surge just kicking Brent while on the mat, like shoving a rug back into place, and Brent is feeling all of that. Yeah, that's it. He was checking him. Thank you, Malice. I think we have another seat if you want to come here and help us out with play-by-play. Oh, and a kick right to the thigh, then to the belly button, basically kicking him everywhere that is not his short and curlies. Anarchy actually watching the match, and I applaud her for that.
And he just keeps stomping on him.
Yes, repeated stomps. Brent's feeling it in his head. He kicked him so hard to the stomach that Brent is feeling it in his head. And that is, that can be a submission. To just kick somebody repeatedly until they give up.
Well, it has happened before.
Yes, yes, I rather not talk about that. That was a sad day in wrestling history, but now Dominic Surge picking Brent up. Dominic not ready to finish this one. He could have pinned him there, but you never know. Brent could have kicked out. Dominic Surge playing it smart here as he flings Brent towards the ropes. Brent sliding along the ropes and slamming into the corner. Dominic Surge side-eyeing Anarchy there for a minute. Again, playing it smart. You never know, the wild card indeed in the ring is Anarchy Warblood. Dominic Surge backing up. He is sizing Brent. He is targeting him. Dominic Surge running in and an vicious corner splash. Just all the momentum and body slamming against him. And with the ricochet, a huge steel lariat. Brent Darkstorm actually bouncing in a ricochet fashion out of the corner to get caught with the steel lariat. I think Brent's ears are hurting at this point. There's just so much pain reeling through Brent Storm's body as Dominic Surge picks him up again. And just, I know it's hard to tell because of his glowy eyes thingy that he has going on there, but Dominic Surge is scowling. He is scowling.
How can you tell?
I have good vision. Oh, wait, he's got him. Looks like he's up for a powerbomb, but no! He switches it, hooks the leg, and Project X! Holy gamanali! I'll make it up worse now, I don't care! Brent Darkstorm, just a carcass on the mat being thrown around. And Anarchy's gonna call this one. She doesn't even need to get down. There's one, there's two, there's three. That's it! Ladies and gentlemen, your winner via pinfall, Dominic Surge!
God, Xander, just take on my job.
I do! I was excited!
All of our jobs.
Everybody's fired except me. Alright. And this next match is scheduled for one fall. Come out first! Oh, wait, no, that's your job.
Ladies and gentlemen, the man of all talents.
Yeah, you should see me crochet. I'm amazing at it.
So that's how you got that armor.
Yeah, I worked hard and I paid for it with money. Dominic a little uncharacteristically doing a victory lap, but he earned it. He earned it for that one. And bravo to him. Wait. I don't know what that means. We'll have to figure that out.
I don't know what that means either.
I don't know. Maybe it was derogatory, like thanks champ, thanks pal, thanks chief. And Opie over here staring at Yuki. Seems much more interesting there. It's another mask there off. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Mask Sunday. So welcome to Mask Sunday. If you have a mask, go ahead and put it on. Just make certain there's no scripts in it. And it's okay. And it's beautiful. Wow, heavy eye contact and a nod from Ophelia. No words exchanged. Just very, very knowing looks between the two. I feel there's history there. So stay tuned,
yeah,
ladies and gentlemen.
There's definitely history there.
Well, stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen, to find out the history of that. It should be revealed in weeks to come.
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Next matchup. Scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, at 5'3", 113 pounds, from Anarchy's Laboratory, Ophelia Bell. And her opponent, the Lucha Doll. Soledad, standing at 5'7", 139 pounds, and from Montreal, Mexico.
Monterrey.
Yeah, I was just about to say that.
I just don't want you getting attacked, Kat. You just don't need to get attacked.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. I got a little sidetrack there, you know. I had commentary on my end. Yes, on that goes out and empieza el hunger. Para bailando y entrele nosotros el festejo. There's something you can tell me, quiero beber ron. The night never ends y seguimos hasta que salga el sol. And the strip looking lit, I about to heat up. Llegó la mami que todo desespera. Te deja boca abierta cuando esta negra llega. Oh no, they're trying to keep up, but they're just too slow. They think that I'm the one, but they just don't know. I'm always balling, I've been doing my thing. No tengo por qué hacer yo. All right, the Lucha Doll and the Ophi Doll are in the ring. It's going to be a doll fight, so welcome to this, ladies and gentlemen. A treat for everybody. Although this is not going to be your typical doll fight, I say that much. Oh, Ophi's just in the middle of the ring before the bell rings. I applaud the enthusiasm.
And it is going to be a interesting match here.
Yes, Anarchy saying that you hurt my wife, I'll murder you. Well, that's so much for unbiased wrestling. But like I said, she's the wild card. Oh, calm down. It should be a fair match between the two of them. I think you're safe, Soledad. Aw, thank you for giving a nice curtsy in respect. I like that.
Looks like some shots fired up there.
No. This is what's called being respectful. This is between two people. So.
I don't mean the curtsy.
Oh, from Anarchy, all she knows how to do is fire shots.
No,
that's
I
awesome.
Meant from Soledad asking Anarchy if he's still awake.
Oh, she knows. She knows. But there had been some confusion.
I think everybody here knows.
Both ladies just circling around each other, eyeing each other up, trying to figure out a game plan, possibly, or a strategy of some sort. Either that, or they just are appreciating each other. You know, nice boots. Great way to keep yourself in tone and shape. You know, nice hair color. Things like that. Things people do. Oh no, they gotta let it build up. It's anticipation. Let's calm down there a minute, lady. Alright. Some things take time to percolate, to marinate. And that's what's happening right now, letting that anticipation build. Building it up. See, they like their hair and the reacquainting. themselves with one another, because it has been quite a while since they faced each other. This is good. I like this. Because come on now, the hunt is more sweeter than the kill. That's it. They're hunting each other right now.
Any thoughts on what I asked you? Hope he just asked that to Soledad.
Oh, a proposition has been placed before us.
I'm with Anarchy on this one.
Oh, does she need to solidify any points? I think that was like maybe like a 30% pun, so I don't think Ophi's in danger of being fired, because that was only 30% of a pun. So no points need to be solidified. Okay, see, I like where this is going. Oh, Ophi glaring at her wife? That's a... turn of events, and yes, you're having a conversation here, so let's follow the conversation. Okay. Well, there's a lot of thinking going on in the ring, but it's leading to somewhere. It is indeed leading to somewhere.
My hair is going gray.
I think it started out that way.
Oh, we got a lockup!
Here we go! The doll's locking up! Trying to jockey for position, just back and forth as a little rocking. Ophi has the good base right there. If you can see that great positioning, they have gravity on her side, but all of that looks to be a smidgen stronger. And Ophi strikes. She gets that wrist lock in. Ophi is saying that she has a few openings in her organization, and that is in, you know, finger bunny quotes. That's all I can do. I don't know what she said, but emphasizing organization. Soledad trying to smack herself out.
That is an interesting thing.
Yes, releasing the wrist lock. And now Soledad looking towards the crowd, then towards Anarchy, then back to Ophi, wanting to know what's the organization or what's the openings. Let's find out. Oh!
And now they're back to circling each other.
Ophelia offering a position in Ophelia's organization to Soledad. The Ophi doll and the Lucha doll conducting some business while conducting some fighting as another lockup is applied. They're tense, but the ladies keeping a little distance from each other. There is nothing malicious about this. There's no ill intent, seemingly. And Soledad has an idea, like a light bulb came off. And Ophelia's organization cleans things up, and something tells me they're not trying to be the maid dolls. So I'm guessing clean things up has a completely different meaning. And Kazuko saying to decline the offer from the audience. Let's see if they'll listen to the audience.
Do any wrestlers ever listen to the audience?
I try to. Now, Ophelia giving a genuine compliment, telling Soledad that you are a really good person. And Soledad really is. Soledad really is.
I think Anarchy is getting pissed now.
There is some frustration to hurry this along, because Anarchy is impatient. But Ophelia is stating, and I need a few really good people to help me out.
I'm not sure what she's talking about, but I would volunteer. I like a good surprise.
Hey, can you guys discuss this later?
No, I think they're going to discuss this further. So, Ophelia says she's going to hit someone.
Maybe they're counting to 100 and throwing a punch at 97 because, you know, nobody will expect that.
I don't know, but I'm thinking at any given moment, Anarchy's just going to get in there and beat the hell out of both of them. Like, Ophelia says, let's go discuss this over crepes.
Wait, what the hell?
Oh, they're thin little pancake type deals. They're very famous, and I think they come from
France. They're leaving!
Why isn't anybody beating anybody?
Are you kidding me? Get your asses back here and fight!
I gotta say this, I actually agree with Anarchy for once. Okay. What just happened?
I don't even know.
Wait, what?
Greeting, AOW.
What?
And Damien, I know you're listening as well. I am coming back to get my revenge on you.
No.
And there's nothing. And no one.
No.
That can stop me. You, along with AOW, will suffer, Damien, for what you did to me all those years ago. And I will make sure you all suffer for what happened to me.
I am not sure what just happened. I'm with Giselle. Maybe he went for crepes too. They made him hungry. Is he coming back? Maybe he'll bring me crepes. That'd be nice.
I don't know. I kinda... maybe event time? Sponsors?
Yeah. How about we roll some sponsors out here? Let's see. We're gonna do my notes. Are you tired of driving so far to see a KOW show? Do you want a place to live that's so close you never miss a show? King's Towers is the place for you. We have luxury condos ready for immediate move-in at a reasonable price. Come on over and check us out at the King's Towers condos. The Kingdom Shopping Center in Bazaar. Shops and kiosks are now available for rental. Be a part of the Kingdom Commerce. Contact any of the members of KOW Parliament for information. Of course, you could not forget Puppy Dog or even Honey Bun's Design. Have you ever wanted to have KOW merchandise in the real world? Real world? Now you can take us with you on the run or any place. Check out our store. And I am going to put that link right in the chat so that you can find it. Top Hats. Top Hats Club, where we cater to all genres of music
and all species of Avatar. We're located in Worldwide City, where anything can happen. Top Hat still features our Wednesday after show. Be there or miss out. Seraphic Graphics, where photography and art come together in Second Life. Do you need pictures taken, an event photograph, or even just need a new profile picture or custom graphic made? Maybe you need a wallpaper to celebrate your relationship, marriage, or even your new shoes. Or a banner or graphic to jazz up your Facebook presence. Seraphic Graphics is just the place you're looking for, with easy-to-afford, case-by-case custom rate plans based on what you want and need. Seek out KOW's Vega Ayano today for more information. The Second Life Cheerleading Squad, established in 2007. Are you looking for a professional motivated team to perform at your venue or event? Contact Shauna Trang or Lorelei Kessel, resident, for more information. The Drivers of SL organizes weekly good drives where participants use their own vehicles to travel from location to location by the 10x10 by GPS navigation hub. For more information, contact Christy Sharon or join the group. And I'm about to toss that out there for you. And that is a word from our sponsors. Back to your regularly scheduled show.
But that is a lot of sponsors, you know?
That is a lot.
KOW is doing pretty good. So,
Okay, Fresh Fry just saw. But that man ran like he was on a mission or something. Or running for his life.
Yeah, that's kind of what looked like was happening there.
Well, that's our Damien Hex. I mean, he runs from a lot of things, and that troubles me. What was it, a goose? A Canadian goose the last time? He runs from geese. He runs from a laugh. He runs from quite a bit.
Yeah, well, every chance he's coming back, I should step in there and say some of my words. Take his place for a bit.
Careful. So, Anarchy, I'm going to have to toss this one to you and hate to ask you a question because, you know, I don't know about the answers half the time. But so, Anarchy.
I think Anarchy wanted blood in that fight.
What say you? This, Mr. Sanzo here wants to hop the barricade.
Yeah, my controller's just acting a little wonky here, trying to get it to respond.
I feel like this should be Jeopardy music playing.
Yeah, I'm waiting for the music to play.
Wait.
Okay.
I wanted to lick my boots.
Oh my god, I just saw Damien crop ass me.
Yeah.
Damien,
is he gone?
No, he's still right there. There he is.
He's gonna get you, Damien.
It's gotta be whoever the fuck has been fucking with me all these weeks. It has to be.
Absolutely.
You don't know who it is?
No.
Oh, Yuki, don't be making those noises. Damien will run again. You know he's a flight risk.
That's rude, but funny.
All right, well, I'm glad we got all of that out of the way. And yes, excellent, excellent sponsors. We love our sponsors. We show love here. I am a big fan of that. I'm a big fan of the sponsors.
Yeah,
I don't know, to be honest, Anarchy. It's Empire. You know, it's Kingdom of Wrestling. Like, anything can happen. Somebody can straight try to Harry Potter you. And that sounded more kinky than I meant.
Words right out of my mouth.
That sounded way more kinky than... Oh! Oh, that's always a good little ditty. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's the Killer Bee. Well, the hyper Legata Loca just kind of backflipped her way out of the castle. Let's see if we can get her back in here. Somebody start rattling candy. Okay, we need to start rattling candies. Let's all get our candies out and then start getting her back. Let's get Gata back.
Everybody need to go and find her.
Yes. Well, it's okay, Ashy Cat. We still appreciate you.
Somebody throw down some catnip.
Yes. We need catnip. There you go. Catnip and candy mixed all together in a bag. Oh, she will come flying back. So, if anybody has candy, just pull it out now. Just crinkle the wrapper. If you crinkle the wrapper, that might get her here, because she's a cat. So, Anarchy having just a genuine disposable conversation with a bee and...
Oh, hold on, I found something.
Wow, that is really loud.
Come on, Gata. Come on, Gata. Where are you?
Oh, wait, I think it worked. Okay, you can pause now. Let's pause that. All right, there she is. There's Gata. Welcome back, Gata. She's over there next to the Facebook. If you want to go ahead and click on that. Check out our Facebook. Lots of stuff happening there. All the information, keeping everybody up to date. You never know. So if we ever get, like, John Moxley to come here, that's the first place we'll announce it, is on the Facebook
Don't
page.
Tease me.
Ha!
Well, I keep getting them to try to, you know, hire Daphne, but that's not going to happen. And the bee puns have begun. Gotta looking leerily in the ring. Gotta intelligent as a little sweetheart. She is intelligent. And when you see Killer Bee and Anarchy in the same ring, you're going to be tentative to get in there as well. So I don't blame Gata taking a little bit more time. Gata's eyes just shifting back and forth between the two, uncertain of who she trusts less.
The bee puns are just fucking funny.
Yes, the bee puns are abundant.
But okay, maybe we shouldn't drone on about it.
I see what you did there.
Well, at least the queen is in here. She'd be buzzing mad.
Oh my lord. Quit while you're ahead.
Oh, come on, that was a good one.
There is the bell, and this one has begun as Killer Bee is staring down the Gata Loca. Killer Bee to the middle of the ring, welcoming Gata to come join her. A nice invitation as Gata uncharacteristically strolls to the middle of the ring. Normally she would be like a pinball just bouncing all over the place. Lock up applied. Looks like Killer Bee is trying to get at Legata with those antennae. Kind of dagger, but all she do is tap and mask, so she's tapping her mask with them, which could throw someone's rhythm off. Both ladies jockeying for position, and where Gata has the height, Killer Bee has the good base situation there for to get in there. You want to keep yourself low. Oh, and a nice cranking wrist lock from La Gata Loca. And now she's wrenching it. Oh, look at that. She's trying to dislocate the everything. And I know that's supposed to be my thing, but let's not talk about that. Ah, wrenching the wrist lock and slipping it right into a hammer lock. Loving the chain. I am loving the chain maneuvers here. One right after the other, and Gata is keeping control while Killer Bee is trying to get back into this. Oh, Killer Bee quickly slipping out of that one. I blinked, and it was done. Now we got two ladies of speed facing off against each other, but they're keeping it slow, and I appreciate that. I actually like that. A big drop kick right to the antennae and face and mask, just all of the frontal cranium area, and a lovely standing moonsault. So much grace, so much feline grace from La Gata Loca. She's the candy girl, and that's okay. Killer Bee is down. La Gata Loca is eyeballing her. Oh! Quickly holding the shoulders down. Both shoulders wiggling down. And there they are. Oh! Barely. Barely. Anarchy standing. The shoulders were not down. By the time Gata got the shoulders down, Killer Bee responded in kind by getting up at a quick nip up from Killer Bee. La Gata Loca gaining some distance, going to try to use some of that lucha high flying, hopefully, to get back into this one, to keep the Killer Bee down. Sometimes when you're being chased by a Killer Bee, it's not all that easy to get away. And oh, rolling through, and no, Killer Bee catching her in that hip toss, but I think La Gata slipped through it. And yes, she did. Okay, La Gata Loca landing on the side of her thigh there. which is very minimal impact, in that when she rolled through, she comes back, Killer Bee catches her in an armbar takedown. Armbar! And yes, everyone can indeed swarm out the bee parts. Go right ahead. But our very own Oakley is much better at it than I am.
Hey, Yuki is getting a few good ones in, too.
Yes. Yes, she is. Yes, she absolutely is. That armbar cinched in nicely there. You see how Killer Bee keeps the arm behind her? That is for a maximum pain, and it gives Killer Bee a lot. There's a lot she can work with there. Or she could actually drop down, slip it under, and turn it into a Ronda Rousey-style armbar. No! Killer Bee just releases the arm and picks Gata up. Gata coming off the ropes. Killer Bee bouncing out. Killer Bee off the ropes. Wraps up the legs, and a bulldog connects! Oh, I thought Gata caught her, but Killer Bee was way too cunning for that. Oh, dropping down, punch the thigh, and a jawbreaker drops Gata. Killer Bee picking Gata back up. The crowd is very torn here between wanting to cheer for Killer Bee and boo her. Oh, and Gata responding with a jawbreaker of her own. Killer Bee did not see that one coming. Killer Bee down, Gata trying to regroup herself, trying to get back from that, and a nice acrobatic poise to her feet. I like that. I just do. I like that when everybody does that. Okay, not everybody. I couldn't do that. Gata poising Killer Bee in a position here. Let's see what Gata has in store as she keeps Killer Bee right where she wants her. Irish whip to the ropes and no! Killer Bee springing off them and a spinning head scissors takes Gata down. I hate to say it, but Killer Bee is out loca-ing La Gata Loca. She is out lucha-ing the lucha. That is sad. And a sitting flip face buster coming through. That is a very devastating maneuver. Oh, comes in and match books in a pin attempt. There's one. There's two. Only a two count. Somehow Gata kicking out of that. Perhaps Killer Bee hitting that one a little too early. Because normally that maneuver right there could end the match. But this one continues. Gata digging down deep. Finding a way to fight back. But Killer Bee poisoning her into position again. Gets her up there for a gut buster, a nice switch hook gut buster there, or a waistlock gut buster, if you will, and Killer Bee is, okay, a little something for the fans. I guess Killer Bee is enjoying all the applause. Killer Bee roughly yanking her to her feet and flinging Gata into the corner. Killer Bee rushing in, and then she just grabs Gata Loca by the mask and starts driving the knees into the corner there. Now she's driving her shoulder, working on the midsection of Gata Loca, I guess. If you can't breathe, you can't run. Oh, and a fisherman suplex into the pin. There's one, there's two, and only a two count. Only a two count as Killer Bee is back at it. And oh! La Gata Loca sweeping the leg. And she did not have a problem with that. Now Gata getting up in the air. Oh! And a diving backflip leg drop crashing down onto Killer Bee.
Killer B feeling all of that one. Oh, and a nice leg drop there, keeping it standardized simple, changing up the tempo. Now, if you watch Gato really closely, she is going to bring the tempo up, then drop it back down, and that's how you get the opponent to be confused. I am really enjoying this strategy. And, oh no! Oh no! Oh no, she wraps her up into a small package! Here we go, there's one, two! Oh, Killer B barely getting the shoulder up, but it's been reversed! It's been reversed! Wait, almost there! Her shoulders are almost down! Killer B fighting, and there it is! One, two! Only a two count, only a two count. Thank you, Crystal. I almost called that one. Whew, that was close. Thank you for keeping me on my toes. Ah, Killer B, not happy with that two count.
Well, that was almost unbelievable.
Okay, there you go. There you go. Keep them rolling. Oh, both ladies just hurting.
Yeah, they're still down. Wait a minute. Gata's getting up now.
Gata doing a little stretch. Now she's back into this as she picks up the B. Getting Killer B into position here. Let's see what Gata has in store. Uppercut right to the non-mentionables, and then an eye rake. Oh,
hey,
that is just.
I don't think anarchy cares as long as it's violent.
This is true. This is very true. And
headlock takedown
into the takedown, and Killer B holding Gato right down there. She's grinding that in. Gata keeping her arm up to show that her shoulder is up. There is no pin attempt here, but this is all kinds of pain as Killer B is cranking on that neck. Wait a minute. Gata trying to fight back, trying to push herself up, using those long legs while Killer B's center base is... she's still got the leverage. But Killer B has taken some of that leverage away. Oh, Killer B not having that. Kicking Gata in the stomach. Coming off the rope, springing down, and a shoulder hop diving DDT.
Gata must be stinging in pain right now.
Yes, she must. And the stings continue. As Killer B just kicks away at Gata. Now she's going to hook the leg. The leg is hooked, rolling her up there. And nope, shoulders are down. One, two, only a two count. Killer B quickly getting Gata right back where she wants her. And she stares down at her. Oh, a kick to the midsection. Killer B coming off the ropes quick-like. And oh! The Killer B sting! Holy bottom of words!
I have no idea what you just said.
Yeah, I don't either. I'm looking at you like, the fuck are you smoking? What the hell did you just say?
The Killer B sting just connects. The Gata dazed as Killer B just signaled that this one may be coming to a close in a moment. Now, I think Killer B has some words for Gata, but I couldn't hear. Turns her around, hooks her in the suspension. Oh, Gata is flailing, trying to get out of it. Trying to somehow loosen that. And down she goes for the honey drop. Killer B hooking the leg. We've got one, We've got two and three. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner via pinfall, Killer Me! Oh, come on! Come on, Killer B! No, it's over! Oh, Killer B hooking
Giles. And she puts her up in the suspension again!
This is just uncalled for.
Wait, what the hell?
What? Emma! Emma Greymas! Oh, just the presence.
Just flew away.
Oh, shit! Oh, they're here! Killer B trying to get away. Emma giving chase. Emma Greymas chasing Killer B. Killer B backing up. I'm not going to say that is fear so much as it is intelligence. Killer B just getting done through an arduous match. Wait a minute, Emma. Emma's staring Killer B down. Ooh. Oh, Killer B is backed up. Now Emma telling Killer B to get out of here. Killer B being a little rebel over there. Yes, that escalated so quickly. Oh my goodness. But Killer B is keeping her head on a swivel there. And Killer B is taunting Emma, saying what's wrong, and smirking at her. Okay, so this seems to be a plan that Killer B has turned. Emma saying, oh, really?
Emma can say, he just said, fuck this, and left.
Yeah, she's gone. Killer B seems to be opportunistic right here. She seems to turn this to her advantage somehow, as if did Killer B knew that Emma would come out? I'm starting to feel like this is some kind of trap, because where I thought Killer B was just trying to get distance and get away from Emma, no, it's back to it's back to being opportunistic, as Killer B says, what do you want? What? Why have you interfered? Wait a minute. Emma Greymas is getting close, but it looks like it's less furious rage and more intelligent conversation. Oh, Emma Greymas pleading with Killer B, what the hell happened to you? I'm very much siding with Emma on this. I want to know the answer to that question.
Your girlfriend put her in psychiatric care and she probably didn't fucking need it?
She can't really do that. She just agreed with the psychiatrist that Killer B needed more psychiatric treatment. And yeah, Emma, you should really listen to KC. You should stay away from her because she's not thinking straight.
I think she's probably thinking straighter than she ever has before.
Well, then I guess that is just a matter of opinion. I feel it should be the opinion that we want to make the world better, not worse. And Killer B says, you know what? I've had enough. And no! A kick to Emma's gut! She comes back, and oh, the Killer B sting! him a no.
And then Killer B just leaves.
Aw, Killer B. What the hell? That was just uncalled for, but no. Oh, Emma's stating this is not over as Emma is getting up on her own accord, on her own power. All right. Good job, Emma. Just walk it off. As Emma stated, this is not over. So we have definitely not seen the last of this interaction. Well, folks, that was our main event.